Has it been confusing for the police when they've received something like 200 inquiries from people who've got missing relatives?
It's a very systematic process. I went to meet the people responsible for how they determine whether people are then included as likely victims, and they rate them on a scale. And they need to have evidence of somebody who's missing, and they need to have some evidence of personal possessions from the scene. And this latest figure, which we hope is going to be the final figure of 11, I hope will be quite an accurate one. But, I mean, the problem is that you've got lots of local people who might be there and people will know that they're there. You might have lots of people on holiday, people on holiday from abroad, not expected home for a week or so, and nobody knows that they're actually going to be or planning to go to the Shoreham air show. So how do you know about them as well? It's not an easy job, and particularly when you're dealing with such a scene of big destruction where bodies are just not identifiable, obviously, in many cases as well.
So what is the next step? I know there's an awful lot of tributes about to take place. Can you tell us something about those?
Well, we've got to the stage where today, hopefully, the police and the forensic will end their combing of the whole site and hand it back
over. And the rain hasn't helped.
And the rain has slowed things down. The rain slowed the taking away of the plane, the fact that also they had to make sure the ejector seats were disarmed, otherwise they could have exploded around the rescuers, as well as extending the search into some of the bushes as well, because various people and equipment thrown forward. And the rain has really not helped. But they've had to do a really thorough job. It's literally fingertip. And we owe it to the relatives to get every piece of evidence there possibly is to piece together the full story of what happened.